as a bending, bending test. That is also a three-point bending it is actually. How it is going to be a three-point bending means, I am going to show you that. This is a one point, this is a one more point, and this one is a third point. By using these three points, we are going to conduct the test called as a bending, three-point bending. Three-point bending by using a material in wood. We are going to make use of wood as a material to test. This one the specimen which we are going to make use. This specimen we are going to make use of, and we are going to place it here. As it is going to come at this particular point, and we are going to apply the load. Due to the applied load, it is going to be it is going to make a bow type of shape. Also, we can call it as a sagging is going to happen. Later on, it cracks. To do this experiment, what we need is we need a set of things. Just you look here. We need a one steel rule, vernier caliper, and specimen. This is a bending specimen which we are going to make use, and we should have a universal testing machine with a bending attachment. This is a bending attachment. This attachment can be dismantled. Okay, the loading is done by this particular point. This is a loading unit of our universal testing machine. That is a testing point of our universal testing machine. Okay, first what we have to do is we are going to measure the entire length of the specimen. Just you see here, the entire length of the specimen is 520 mm, also you can call it as a 52 centimeters. Okay, we are going to find its center. We are going to find the center of this specimen is 26 centimeter or 260 mm. I am measuring here. So what we are going to do is we are going to find its center first. So from this center, we have to equally distribute this length. This length is called as a span distance, because we are going to place this specimen here like this. So this distance is called as a span distance that we are going to measure. How much it is there? Just we'll check the span distance. Span distance is 320 mm. You can see this is a span distance which is 320 mm. We are going to take these two centers properly. Okay, 320. Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to leave, or we are going to distribute equally 160 mm in 160. This is a 160, and another side also 160 mm. Just we will mark this properly to place it equally. So simply we will mark it. Okay, so we will place the center point side spans at this particular point. We are going to carry it here on this, and we will place it here. You can see this. You can see. Okay, span distance. Okay, so now what we will do is just we are going to bring down the crosshead. This is called as a crosshead. We are going to bring down. So just we are going to bring down. And it will be just touch untouch. It should be at that particular point. As we are going to apply the load on this, it is going to take a bend. That bend is measured here. You can see this. The measurement of bend is going to be taken place at this particular point. Okay, this is showing zero there. That is the point where the bending is measured. That means how much it is going to make a bend. Okay, that is going to be measured. And how the load is applied here. The load applied on this will be very gradual. That is, every 10 division is going to give you 1 kilonewton of a load.
So once if it starts and moves to the 1 kiloNewton, we are going to call it as a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. It may go up to 10, 15 or something else, 20 kiloNewtons of load it may take. Later on it breaks. The specimen when breaks, this needle will come back. That means the experiment is completed. We are going to show you the conduction of an experiment for you in next video. Okay?